Have you ever wondered what would happen if you took a famous story everybody knows and changed one particular thing about it? Experience the pungent result in this Read Aloud with Mr. Paul. Welcome to Read Aloud with Mr. Paul. I'm so glad you could be here. Be sure to subscribe so you won't miss a single story. Today, we'll be reading The Stinky Cheese Man. From The Stinky Cheese Man and Other Fairly Stupid Tales by John Scieszka and Lane Smith. Here's our title page. The Stinky Cheese Man and Other Fairly Stupid Tales. Once upon a time, there was a little old woman and a little old man who lived together in a little old house. They were lonely. So the little old lady decided to make a man out of stinky cheese. She gave him a piece of bacon for a mouth and two olives for eyes and put him in the oven to cook. When she opened the oven to see if he was done, the smell knocked her back.
Phew, what is that terrible smell? She cried.
The stinky cheese man hopped out of the oven and ran out the door, calling, "Run, run, run as fast as you can! You can't catch me, I'm the stinky cheese man!" The little old lady and the little old man sniffed the air.
"I'm not really very hungry," said the little old man. "I'm not really all that lonely," said the little old lady.
So they didn't chase the stinky cheese man. The stinky cheese man ran and ran until he met a cow eating grass in a field.
"Wow! What's that awful smell?"
said the cow. The stinky cheese man said,
"I've run away from a little old woman and a little old man, and I can run away from you too, I can. Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the stinky cheese man."
The cow gave another sniff and said,
"I'll bet you could give someone two or three stomach aches. I think I'll just eat weeds."
So the cow didn't chase the stinky cheese man either. The stinky cheese man ran and ran until he met some kids playing outside school.
"Gross," said a little girl. "What's that nasty smell?" "I've run away from a little old lady and a little old man and a cow, and I can run away from you too, I can. Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the stinky cheese man."
A little boy looked up, sniffed the air, and said, "If we catch him, our teacher will probably make us eat him. Let's get out of here." So the kids didn't chase the stinky cheese man either. By and by, the stinky cheese man came to a river with no bridge.
"How will I ever cross this river? It's too big to jump, and if I try to swim across, I'll probably fall apart," said you-know-who.
Just then, the sly fox, who shows up in a lot of stories like these, poked his head out of the bushes.
"Why, just hop on my back and I'll carry you across, stinky cheese man."
"How do I know you won't eat me?"
"Trust me," said the fox.
So the stinky cheese man hopped on the fox's back. The fox swam to the middle of the river and said,
"Oh man, what's that funky smell?" The fox coughed, gagged, and sneezed,
and the stinky cheese man flew off his back and into the river, where he fell apart. The end. Here are three things I notice about this story. First, I can't help but notice the story is a twist on another famous nursery rhyme.
What was the name of that one again? Oh yeah, the Gingerbread Man.
Also, I remember that the Gingerbread Man has a lesson in it, what we call a moral, about the danger of bragging that you're the fastest and no one can catch you. The Gingerbread Man's boastfulness gets him eaten by the tricky fox. The Stinky Cheese Man, on the other hand, has no such moral, no lesson that I can find at the center of it. Instead, it's silly fun. I mean, you could argue that the Stinky Cheese Man suffers from an inaccurate self-concept, which leads to his downfall, but let's never mind that now. I think the story is written as pure entertainment, made to delight us. And that's enough. Finally, it's fun to notice which things Scieszka and Smith kept from the original and which they changed. First is the title character. In The Gingerbread Man, he's made of something so sweet-smelling and delicious, everyone he meets wants to eat him. The Stinky Cheese Man is made of things that are unappealing by themselves, like stinky cheese, or things that just don't go together, like olives and bacon. The twist is very clever. I can just imagine Scieszka and Smith hatching the idea. Instead of being highly desirable, like the Gingerbread Man, so everyone would chase him, what if our character were made of highly undesirable things, but still believed everyone wanted to eat him? What would happen then? From that funny idea, they could figure out how the story would unfold in a funny way. When you write your next story, see if you can take something that everybody knows, twist it in an interesting way, then keep asking yourself what happens next until you get to the end. Thank you so much for joining me for Read Aloud with Mr. Paul. Until next time, discover the wonder in a book. Pick one up. Take a look.
If you enjoyed this Read Aloud with Mr. Paul, please like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. Thanks again.